हेलो फ्रेंड्स, इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू सॉल्व एक्सरसाइज क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम बुक टॉपिक्स इन अलजेब्रा। सो क्वेश्चन इज द सेंटर जेड ऑफ अ ग्रुप जी इज डिफाइंड बाय जेड इज सेट ऑफ ऑल दोज एलिमेंट्स जेड इन जी सच दैट जेड एक्स इज इक्वल टू एक्स जेड फॉर ऑल एक्स इन जी। देन वी हैव टू प्रूव दैट जेड इज अ सब ग्रुप ऑफ जी। ऑल्सो वी हैव टू डिटरमाइन वेदर कैन वी रिकोगनाइज Z as centralizer of some subgroup T of group G. So let's start our proof. To prove that center is a subgroup of G, we will use the lemma: a non-empty subset H of a group G is a subgroup of G if and only if for all elements AB in H, A star B inverse is also an element of H. Now here G is a group and Z is clearly a subset of G. Here Z is collection of all those elements in group G which commutes with all other elements of group G. Now to prove Z is a subgroup, firstly we will check whether Z is non-empty or not. For this, observe that E, that is identity element of a group G, commutes with all other elements of a group G, and thus by definition identity element will be an element of center of a group G. Therefore center of group G is always a non-empty set. Now consider two elements, say Z1 and Z2, in center of group G. Therefore Z1 will commute with all element of a group G, similarly Z2 will commute with all elements of a group G. Now in order to show Z1 is a subgroup, we have to show that Z1 Z2 inverse is also an element of center. That is, we have to show that Z1 Z2 inverse commute with all elements of group G. So we will do that. For all X in G, consider Z1 Z2 inverse X. Now this can be written as Z1 Z2 inverse X Z2 Z2 inverse, since here we can consider identity element and identity element can be written as Z2 Z2 inverse. Now using associativity in a group G, this expression can be rewritten in this form. Now as Z2 is an element of center, XZ2 can be written as Z2X. In the next step, Z2 inverse Z2 will become identity, so no need to write that, and we get this expression. Now for this step, as Z1 is an element of center, so Z1x will be XZ1, and using associativity we get this step. Now observe that we have started from here and we end up with here, so we get Z2, Z1 Z2 inverse X is equal to X Z1 Z2 inverse. That is, Z1 Z2 inverse X commute with all elements of a group G. Thus Z1 Z2 inverse is a member of center of group G. So by this lemma we have Z, that is center of group G, is a subgroup of G. Now in the question they have asked to determine whether we can recognize center of group G as centralizer of some subgroup of G. For this, firstly we will recall what is mean by centralizer of a subgroup of group G. So we know that if Z is some subgroup of G, then the centralizer of H is the set of all elements X in G such that all these elements must commute with all elements in subgroup H. So this one is the definition for centralizer of a subgroup of group G. Just we have shown that center is a subgroup of G, and Center is collection of all those elements of a group G which commutes with all other elements of a group G. Now if we try to write centralizer of Z, that will be this set. So from these two definitions of centralizer of a subgroup and center of a group G, we can conclude that centralizer of a center of group G will be equal to center of group G again. So we can recognize center as centralizer of a subgroup which is center of a group G, and this proves our result.